The digital divide has been a pronounced and studied issue for at least 2 decades. Researchers began by measuring the effects of access to information and communication technology, or ICT, and calling attention to the issue. Socioeconomic and race factor into the equation and put many students at a disadvantage. As ICT becomes more ubiquitous and necessary in daily life, the focus turns to the quality and depth of learning and usage of ICT in students. But the socioeconomic and race issues remain. The term digital divide was first coined in 1995 by a New York Law School professor named Alan Hammond. The term began to be used ubiquitously in articles and media reports to describe the disparity in access to computers and the internet, the first level divide, between socioeconomic groups. Households making more money had the resources to purchase home computing equipment and access the internet, and rich schools could provide modern computing technology in the classroom. Poorer households and schools could not, creating a gap in access to information and technology that could potentially help students perform better. In addition, there is the perception that lack of access to ICT, such as computers and their peripheral devices, can cause students to not only lag in the classroom, but be at a disadvantage in the job market as adults. The concepts of digital natives and digital immigrants describe technology users' familiarity of information technology based on the user's age of introduction and use. Being one or the other influences the level of comfort with current and future technology. Currently, in schools, the gap has largely been closed for the past 10 years. Vigder, Ladd, and Martinez note that the typical American school has one computer for every 4 students. Literature from that same study on home computer access rates between 2000 and 2005 showed that lower-income families had a 72% access rate versus 93% for middle- and upper-income families. And students whose parents dropped out of high school had the lowest rate of 65%. Though there are many variables affecting school performance, a student whose household has always owned a computer sees significantly higher standardized test scores. Constraints on ICT access, whether that is slow internet at home or lack of access to any ICT at home, forces users to seek ICT elsewhere, for example, public libraries. With this carries additional expenses such as transportation costs. These additional costs, not only financial, but time as well, this causes students to feel pressured, and time limitations on their ICT usage forces them to ration their time to necessities such as homework, limiting or negating any time spent on social media or other explorations of digital material. This lack of access causes students to see web surfing as an unaffordable luxury and believe that surfing does not benefit their work. These types of attitudes about the benefits of web exploration and the lack of opportunity to surf leisurely impose a constraint on students that may last their whole life. These attitudes may also severely limit the value placed on ICT as a tool for use beyond school assignments and make them ill-prepared as adults using ICT effectively in the workplace. Between and within digital natives and digital immigrants, there lie disparities in both access and ability. With some access gaps slowly improving and with ICT becoming increasingly embedded in all aspects of life, the issues surrounding ICT ability and literacy gaps have become the focus of much of the recent research. Rogers describes the gap in ICT ability as consumption versus production skills, with consumption entailing reading and viewing online digital content and production being the creation of original digital content. Production is the key to economic opportunity in the digital age. Subramoney states that true empowerment through ICT use comes when individuals, groups, and nations possess producer-level ICT knowledge and skills. The inclination of a school to encourage students to be producers of digital content, not just consumers, can be linked with the student's socioeconomic level. There are three levels to the digital divide: access to hardware, frequency of technology use in class, and ICT use for personal empowerment. Research shows that low socioeconomic groups of students are less likely to know how to use ICT for the betterment of their quality of life. Low socioeconomic groups are more likely to be assigned ICT work to perform drill and practice tasks, and higher socioeconomic groups are more likely to be assigned in-class work using productivity software and web exploration. This disparity limits the depth at which many students explore ICT and gain confidence and self-empowerment, which may lead them away from attempting to expand their skills when they are given the opportunity.